Hello, friend. Today, I'm going to share the amazing 1000 Dream Fund.
And I'm going to share about the powerful white oak. Let's get to it.
I'm going to be talking about a movement. This movement is called 1000 Dreams Fund. It is founded by Christine Garten. And 1000 Dreams, not just 100, this is 1000 Dreams, is a bold goal to fund 1000 real girls nationwide with scholarship funding. There are more than 20 million high school and college-age girls in the U.S., each of whom has their own hopes and dreams. But with parents, limited expendable income, high cost of college, these dreams can be out of reach. The 1000 Dream Fund model is to empower you to change that. And that means you as in the dreamers, and also you because you can help. What is your big dream, they ask. The next dream we fund could be yours. And it's beyond the classroom. So girls say that 85% say that extracurricular activities are important for their future, but 95% lack easy access to funding. So this is a micro grant fund where you can help them give money for conferences and training, college and graduate school exam fees, tutoring services, I can't talk today, technology and books for school. So it doesn't really talk about tuition, because that's such a big thing, but it's all the other little things that are just as important. So you can see, you can go to the website and see who's already been funded and check that out. It's a very good diversity of different girls, so I love that. You can apply there, of course, if you're someone looking for help. You can also find who you want to fund. You can join a student advisory board. You can talk about their membership program. There's so many different things. There's tons of different programs they do. The JBO Quantum Grant with 1000 Dream Fund, a member mentor her initiative, a Poali Club, STEAM, so that's music fields, science, technology, engineering, arts, and math. Broadcast her initiative, an all-girl hackathon at Yale. 3 out of 4 of the staff are women. There's blog, website, there's social, there's so many more things. Definitely check out 1000 Dream Fund.
Oh, this is so needed. Yeah. I mean, in the United States, it kills me how expensive college is. And yeah. If that's the thing that's stopping you, if there's not funding, this is magnificent.
Yeah, and it's one of those catch-22 things, right? You need to do more things outside of high school and college to get a good job. Well, to get into college, you need more things. You need to be on the board. You need to go to extracurricular activities and, you know, go to nonprofits and volunteer and all these things. But that also comes with expense and how to get there, how to do things like that. So I love that they're taking this approach of taking care of a lot of the other little things that get overlooked.
Yeah.
Because, a lot of things focus on tuition, and that's super important because that's the biggest one.
Right.
But there's all these other little things that can stop people from reaching their dream, too.
Exactly. And, like, the mentorship, because you might get all the money in the world, and you go to college and you're like, now what do I do? Like, how do I navigate?
Where to start.
And where do I, you know, all of those things. So that's super important too.
Yeah. So cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
they're doing
great.
Some really fun things. They've been going since 2015. So it's not a brand new company or foundation, but it's growing every year. I love it.
Yeah.
So cool.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. You're very welcome.
Sharing that. Great resource. My cool sheet is a species. I don't think I've ever talked about a species as a cool sheet before. This is the Oregon white oak. And the scientific name is Quercus guariana. One of only 4 deciduous oaks native to the West Coast, Oregon white oak. And these trees are towering and they are beautiful, but they are also crucially important. White oak woodlands are so important for wildlife. They provide food and habitat for many species, and diversity of bird species is often higher in oak forests than adjacent conifer forests. And this is partially because of the acorns from the oaks and also the foliage. It provides many high protein foods for a lot of animals. Oregon white oak savannas and woodlands once covered nearly 500,000 acres in western Oregon. And get this, only an estimated 1-5% remain. Ugh. Conservation of land to agricultural and urban uses and the encroachment of conifers have caused a dramatic loss in these habitats. Along with the detriment to animal species of the region, many of the old oaks are connected to tribal families who were here long before European settlers. The Kalapuyan and other tribes depended on oak groves as a source of acorns, also camas, also, and deer, which are important staples in their diet. David Lewis, an anthropologist and member of the Confederated Tribes of Grand Ronde, says that what people don't realize is that the native people of the region were stewards of the land. They did long-term management, and they did this by setting controlled fires and harvesting. And so Lewis and others are trying to dispel this settler narrative that the land in Western Oregon was this clear, empty space ready for farmers to move into. The Oregon White Oak also tells a story of natural history, weather patterns, climate change, in ways that can be provided even before human documentation was possible. And this is done through the Oak Salvage Project. So this is a project being carried out by researchers at Willamette University, where if you lose a white oak that falls naturally because you cannot, it's against the law to cut this down, that you can send then cuts of it called cookies, and they can find out more information about climate change and things like that. This is a beautiful tree. I love this tree. Oregon white oak.
Cool. Yes, those trees are so flipping beautiful.
Yes, yes.
Beautiful. They're magnificent.
I know, and I'm so glad that they are now protected.
Yes, I know, because only 1%?
I know.
And scary.
Those numbers.
It took that long before we started doing something, but we're doing something now.
Yes, exactly.
That's so great.
I know.
Something's happening.
Yeah. It's called the Oregon White Oak, but they are in California, Oregon, Washington, and into British Columbia.
Oh, cool.
And they're native in that region, but they are also endangered in that whole region. So.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and you know, we've never talked about a species before.
Or
species of any kind.
Yeah.
We've talked about different various kinds, you know, tree canopy, what is that called? The canopy.
Tree shyness,
Yeah. That was cool. Sarah talked about the life of trees, something in the book. So yeah, we're tree huggers for sure. So now I'm glad we talked about the white oak.
Yes.
Specifically. That's great. Thank you so much
for
sharing
that. You're welcome.
And if you want to check that out, check out our show notes at tenbestest.com/sidewalk. Maybe you want to get involved. Maybe you just want to learn more. So that's what's there for. Thank you for joining us, friend. I'm Brian Hart.
I'm Karen McFarlane Holman.
Let us know in the comments, what's one of your biggest dreams?
And let us know, can you tell the difference between white oak and other oaks?
If you're enjoying the show, please smash that like and share with a friend.
Stay tuned tomorrow for another great show.
And don't forget to stay curious.